Today is 3rd April 2019. This is the 6-year-old female, not spayed, Pekinese, came for the vaccinations.
Just called vaccination. Any loss of appetite? Inactive? Vomiting? Diarrhea?
No.
Nothing?
No.
Okay. When was the last vaccination done?
2014.
2 years ago? No, 5 years ago. Okay, so before the vaccination, we'll do a wait the dog. I'll put the dog down first. Put the dog there on the weighing machine there. Okay, this is 0?
Yeah.
Okay, let's weigh the dog there. Okay, roughly 6.47, huh?
Yeah.
I can't bring the dog up. Okay, so this is. So normally the procedure is to weigh the dog first before anything else because we have to record all the way. 6.47, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. So you write down 6.47, the weight. Then we'll take a temperature. Can you hold the dog? Does she bite? No, huh? Does she bite?
Depends.
Depends on what? Better let me know. Depends on what?
Depends. You disturb what
you bite. You hold the head. So normally dogs are by rectal temperature. Yeah, some dogs will bite. But most of them don't. Okay, so the rectal temperature is the way we do for dogs. Normally it should be, in Toa Payoh it should be 38 to 39.5 the range. So anything below or above, then it's fever. Other vets may have different ranges. Even the American Kennel Club, they have their own range. So as you can see, this is rectal temperature, 38.2.3, within the normal range. Eating well, right? And then we correlate the signs, whether active, it's very active, not active. So it's normal 38.3. So from here you can see there is no diarrhea. There's no diarrhea. So right now it's 38.3. Then the next thing I do is the physical examination. So normally we start with the head first. They come, you hold the dog second. Now some dogs do bite, so just be careful. It doesn't bite, right? So normally we check the eyes first. Come nearer. We'll have a quick look at the conjunctiva, whether it's anemic or not. Definitely not anemic. Reddish. Then the gums, very good. They're pink. This is called the capillary refill time. We press, the color should come back within 1 second. It's CRT, right? Mm-hmm. CRT is less than 1 second. That means it's good, normal. Then we check the mouth, if the dog allows. In this case, it's allowed. Okay. Now the teeth, generally check the teeth, especially the back teeth. Now there's a tartar here, no?
Mm.
Do you do the dental early on?
No.
Oh, there's tartar here. So this one, if you do dental scaling, then you prevent any more of those abscess later on. Because some owners, they don't do it. This is considered to have extra puppy tooth. This is the extra one, didn't come out, right?
No, I don't know.
Normally the front teeth, they are 6, but this one is 7. So one of them is the puppy one, which didn't drop out. So next I can see 2. There's 2 of them. Okay. So this can be removed during the dental at the scaling.
Is it necessary?
Better because it blocked the other one. Okay, after that I just check the lymph nodes. So just in case any lymphoma. So this one a bit swollen. But not much. Okay, then check generally the lymph nodes. The prescapular. The axillary, the armpit one. So check. Normally, if you don't check, you don't know, you see. Whether there is lymphoma or not. Okay. Check. Okay. This side. Come this side. Come. Nothing. The popliteal is here. Here. No swelling. Okay, but no swelling. Okay. Then I have a quick check of the pain, can hold it off, you know. Hold on bit, huh? Hold on bit. On bit. They come here, come. Put the rope down. Okay, turn up, sit down. Have a quick check below, so.
It's okay.
So it'll come this side. Now, as you can see, the dog has been licking the lower part. Correct?
Yeah.
That's why the hair is not growing. So this dog is feeling itchy from the flooring.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a hernia here. This umbilical hernia. Mm-hmm. And now, normally if the dog is sterilized, then ask the vet to close up the hernia.
Yeah, understand.
Now, you can see that this dog is, you can adjust here. Put around your neck. Okay. So you can see that this dog, when was the last period? Bleeding. Because you can see that it's swollen on this part. It might be somewhere.
No more idea. No more idea.
Let's see, there's somewhere here. But the last period, the heat period. No, I'm talking about the period, the bleeding.
Yeah, February 11.
February, yeah. So now is what?
11 starts, and then after that, drying up is about 18.
Okay, that's good, yeah. So normally it's 2 weeks now?
Yeah.
2 weeks now.
Then the heat starts on 20 years like that, something like that.
No, we're talking about starting of bleeding.
The bleeding is 11.
11 February, so today is what? Today is...
March.
I
don't know, April.
April, so yeah, it stopped already, but what I'm saying is normally the forced pregnancy, where the hormones will make this nipple swollen.
It's you mean like that's swollen?
Forced pregnancy, has the dog been licking herself here? Yeah? You can see that. Because the dog has never given birth, right?
No.
But this part is frozen, so this is called forced pregnancy.
She always licked on the floor everywhere, the hand, the leg, and
everything. I'm talking about that. These are only after about 1 month after the heat.
Oh.
After that, it goes down, right?
Oh.
Okay, then this part is swollen, so it's due to
forced pregnancy.
Licking. Sometimes they have some discharge.
Okay.
So the discharge comes up because.
But she liked to rub, like sit on the back and then.
Oh, that one is the back side. Okay, so now we check the back side. Let's check the back side. No, we just have a quick check. If she rubbed, that means inner glands are full. Do you express it?
Yeah, I do.
You do when? When do you do?
Just 2 days ago, I did.
Did any oil come out?
Little bit.
So if you express it, then it won't be rubbing. Sometimes they bite the tail. Let me just check for you. Yeah, not much left. Not much, only a little bit. This is a normal oil. Okay, normal oil, give to Sue. Okay, that's it. So this should be no problem already. You'll be expressed already. So the last thing I do is the heart and the lungs. Check. For a quick check there. Before we vaccinate. Give to her, then we do the vaccination. Prepare the vaccine. A quick check now. The heart is good. No abnormal lung sounds. I check the abdominal sounds, is there any sounds of the intestinal contractions? Yeah, there are sounds, normal sounds of the gas. Yeah. So this completes the physical examination. The last one is just check any lungs. Check the kidney, the palpation, we call it abdominal palpation. Had a quick check on the kidneys, not swollen, liver not swollen, and no pain. Then we check the intestines, large intestine, quite full. That means she haven't passed motion, right?
Just one small one.
Yeah, but still a lot. Then I check the bladder. The discharge is okay, the period.
Period.
Fresh blood. Is it fresh blood?
Yeah. Finish
already. No, I mean, I just don't know whether it's fresh or not.
Yes.
I can check the uterus also. With experience, you can feel the uterus.
But she don't pass urine that regularly. Like, whole day I don't go home, don't bring her down, she can don't.
Yeah, they control.
Is it good?
No good, but then they are clean. They are cleaned up. Unless you train him to do on the newspaper, you didn't train, right?
Yes, at home, she until she cannot control, she will do it on the newspaper.
But they prefer not to, this dog. It's very clean. So there's no swollen bladder, no swollen kidney, liver, spleen, nothing normal. So overall, this dog is considered normal on physical examination. So we just do the vaccination. So ready? So that's the whole dog.
New model
dog? Well, let me see where's the vaccine card.
This time it's only 9-in-1 from the other clinic, yeah.
I check the vaccination card. Now there are two vaccines. The one is the flu one. Mm-hmm. One is the 9-in-1. So there are two types. So you want to do 2 or 1?
The 9-in-1.
So we will just use the card. See,
okay.
Now the 9-in-1 is to end the vaccination. The card hold the dog. Huh?
Okay.
Just talk. Sometimes the dog is okay. Sometimes.
Okay. Good,
yeah. Usually they're alright, it's under the skin, let's see. Yeah, okay. Finish. So overall the dog is healthy. Just the skin, that's it. And sterilization.
So, when is the best time for sterilizing?
Sterilization, actually now everything is stopped, right?
Yeah.
So the best is about 2 weeks from now. But this part must be clean, you know. The skin is very dirty here. So you have to clean.
Dirty as in what? Need to shower or?
Yeah, the whole thing is you turn upside down. Because the dog's been leaking, right? So there's a lot of small pimples, bacteria in there. So you got to wash it, clean it.
Oh. And then when it comes to that means all this black can go off. Or?
Yeah, it can, but the dog's been leaking it. These are pigmentation due to leaking.
So are these fungus?
No, due to the friction leaking.
Okay.
But there are some bacteria there which we can't see. There's some pimples, you can see there, the rashes here.
So must clean with what?
I give an antiseptic wash.
Sweat?
No, a rainbow wash.
Wash.
Then after that, you wash every day. Then for let's say 10 days, this thing should be white already. Then we give antibiotics. And then so on the day of spaying, let us know that to close up this hole. And do a bit of scaling and this thing.
So how much would it cost?
Okay, finish it then. Yeah.